From the road, you can see a wind turbine is big, but it's hard to know just how big until you're standing next to one. And to really appreciate the size, try looking at it from the inside.
Not everybody knows that you can enter the inside of the wind turbine.
But before you can go in, you need to suit up.
Put on the hard hat, and we'll put on safety glasses. Also gloves for climbing up the ladder. And then the safety harness, which is quite a piece of gear, but it includes what we call the lad safe, the most important part of this, which connects to the wire that vertically parallels the ladder all the way from the basement up to the nacelle.
The turbine tower is hollow. Technicians service and control the turbine from the core.
And it's where the electronics, controls, and breakers for the electrical system and communication systems are located.
There are more controls higher in the turbine. And the only way up is this ladder.
We open the safety gate, and then we put on our lad safe, and we open it up, and then that clamps right onto this wire. And then as you go up, it glides with you, but if you fall, it's going to catch you.
Which is a good thing, since the climb is 260 feet straight up.
26 stories. And it's a vertical climb, so it's a good workout.
This ladder goes all the way to the top of the turbine, which is called the nacelle. Along the way are a few landings.
We are about 70 feet off the up from the base of the turbine. This is where the two tower sections meet. When they install these in the field, this is a place where the wires are connected. We have roughly 200 feet left of vertical climb.
The aluminum ladder is lighter than steel and doesn't need to be attached to the turbine.
Only magnets are what hold this ladder structure to the wind turbine.
That's right, magnets.
They're not mechanically, physically connected. You can see there's a blue magnet right there, and all the way down this ladder is only held to the structure through magnets.
About three quarters of the way up the wind turbine, you see a mass of cables.
It's called a Christmas tree because there's that plastic form that the wires fit through, and it kind of looks like a snowflake, and they tie that to a Christmas tree.
These cables carry the electricity down the turbine, electricity which is generated just a bit higher in the nacelle.
We are in a nacelle of the V82, which is the top of the turbine. This houses the generator, the gearbox, the main shaft, and the rotor. So when the blades spin, the rotor spins, the main shaft spins, and in turn, it turns a generator, and that creates the electricity on the back end. If you look at a wind turbine, it actually looks like a hammer minus the blades, and this would be the top of the hammer or the nacelle.
And from the nacelle, it's just a quick step through a hatch, and you're outside.
We are on top of turbine V9 at the top of Iowa 3 wind farm. Right behind me is the radiator. This radiator actually cools the generator as it generates electricity. If you look at the turbine right next to us, which is V10, you can see the blades turning, and the center of where they turn is called the hub. We are just above the hub. So we are on the top of the turbine.
It is a jaw-dropping view.
We are roughly around 270 feet above ground, and as you look down, you see a lot of corn, soybeans, and a few cattle to our left. So there ends the tour of a wind turbine. Not many people are able to enter inside a wind turbine. There's a lot of moving parts and pieces that generate the electricity. It's not just blade spinning. There's a lot of components that tie that together to bring the energy to your home.
Next time you see a wind turbine, imagine standing on top of one.
I'm king of the world!